The new Flux models for image generation offer extremely high quality and are extremely large, but is there a way to get that high performance even on GPUs with low VRAM? GGF is a well-known format for quantized models with highly reduced size, used for example by Meta's Llama, and now it's available for Flux on ComfyUI with several quantized models, including the smallest one that's just 4 GB. Even better, there is no hassle with the bits and bytes extension like with NF4, and there is already an experimental LoRa support. If you haven't installed ComfyUI yet or need to know how to install Flux on Comfy, watch this video. And for Comfy on Linux, click the link here. In this video, you will learn how to install and integrate the GGF loader in your Comfy workflows, which quantized models to use, and a detailed view on the performance. We start with the installation. As usual, you can find all links in the description. On Comfy Anonymous GitHub page, I was searching for solutions for my problems with the bits and bytes extension. To my surprise, there was a link to a Comfy extension for GGUF. GGUF is a well-known format for quantizing LLMs. It even says that the results of GGUF seem to be better than NF4. Following the link, we find the GitHub page of City96 and the ComfyUI GGUF extension. It brings quantization support for native Comfy models, and it's work in progress, so well, handle with care. And in contrast to other unit models, Flux seems to be well suited for quantization. And that's good for low-end GPUs. First, we need to update ComfyUI. I've shown this in my installation video about ComfyUI. And if you have installed the Windows portable version as shown in the vid, we have to do the following. Copy the command by clicking the small icon on the webpage, and in the command window in the installation directory of your Comfy portable, paste the command. Press return and the GGUF extension is installed. The warning is normal when using the portable version, it shouldn't have any effect. Then you can call the run NVIDIA BAT if you are the lucky owner of an NVIDIA GPU, or run cpu.bat, which is very slow. If you have an AMD GPU with the running SLUDA environment for Comfy, there is an additional step to be done, and NVIDIA users can jump directly to the next chapter. Enter the base directory of your SLUDA installation. Most probably it's a directory for SDNext. Within this directory, you find an venv directory. You should make a backup of this venv directory like I did with the venv works. Sometimes modifications destroy the consistency of the directory, and by having a backup folder, well, you can easily roll back. Enter the following command in order to install the GGUF extension in your SLUDA environment. Enter your Comfy portable directory and start the SLUDA batch file. After a few seconds, ComfyUI has been restarted, including the GGUF extension. Now we need a workflow for Flux. In the ComfyUI examples in Flux, there are the well-known examples for dev and for schnell. We choose the schnell version. We need a new model loader node for GGUF. Yes, it's currently in bootleg. We replace the connections of the old diffusion loader, and the diffusion model loader is not required anymore. Just let's check the instructions. Yeah, we already did that. There's a warning not to install the faucet clip device, so we won't do that. Now it's time to download the GGUF models. The links are on the page with the installation instructions. Under Files and Versions, you find 6 models while making this video. Well, there already have been created several more models, including one model with only a size of 4 GB. We download the Q4O model with less than 7 GB. And the webpage for the dev model, well, it looks very similar, and we have lots of models. On my PC, I have downloaded meanwhile all of the models, both for Schnell as well as for dev. Let's move the downloaded model, place it in ConfUI, models, QNet. You can put all dev and Schnell models there. I think it's good enough to use the refresh button, and then we can see the model. Yes, there is our Schnell Q4O model. I've selected the FP16 text encoder, but for sure you can choose the FP8 version too. It even consumes less VRAM. In order to reduce the required VRAM for our very first run, let's reduce the resolution to 512x512. So let's start our very first run. That was successful. I fast forwarded the generation process, but it took around 25 seconds. What that means, and regarding the overall performance of the new models, well, I'll show you in the end of the video. Now let's generate an image with a higher resolution. For this workflow, I have replaced the text encoder node. You can find it in the advanced section. It takes advantage of the T5 text encoders of the Flux models. I'll make a video about that. In the T5 section of the text encoder, I've already typed in a suitable prompt. The new text encoder node has the same connections as the clip encoder node we have used before. We want to generate an image of the size 1280x720. Again, I've chosen the FP16 text encoder model, and I've downloaded all new GGUF models. Let's select the Schnell Q8O model. Let's see how it works. Well, that's not bad. But what about the quality and performance? I have generated several images with different dev and Schnell models with the same seed. By the way, if you want to see more videos like this, press the subscribe button. Now let's have a look at the images. I have generated 4 images with the same seed. I've used the original Schnell model, so FP16, as well as the FP8 model, and the new Q8O model, as well as the Q4O model. Can you identify which is which? This one looks good, except for, well, this strange color at the fingers. And this one is okay, except for one finger, and well, that should name Flux. Here is the hand, well, somewhere else. And we have an additional finger. And here one finger is missing, or well, behind the sign, who knows. The general composition is good, and yeah, I like that dragon. So let's uncover. Have you expected that? Yeah, the FP16 model seems to be the best one, but the Q8 model is not bad at all, well, except for that strange thing with the finger. These images have been generated with the dev versions. Again, we have FP16, FP8, Q8O and Q4O. Again, can you identify which is which? In fact, I like all of them. The faces are great, and yeah, the dragon, it's very, very fantastic. But the text is only correct in this image. It should be 4 everywhere and not 4R. So, ready to uncover? Yes, the best one is the Q8O model. And in all my tests, it was very close to the FP16 model, so the original one anyhow. FP8 and Q4O, well, they're on par. Now let's have a look at the performance data. That's the resolution I've used, and this is my test system. If we look at the numbers, then we can see that the Q models are much faster, especially for Schnell, but even for Dev, the performance is not bad at all. But here comes a surprise, this is only the half of the truth. The statistics included the loading times of the models. And as the new quantized models are much smaller, well, their loading times are faster, and so in this comparison, they seem to be faster. But if we neglect the loading time, then it's all more or less on the same level. That's both true for Schnell as well as for Dev. So if you are surprised, I was too, and I thought about, well, maybe I haven't considered something. In fact, 16 GB VRAM is not that much, and the model simply didn't fit into the VRAM, at least not for this resolution. So I made some more tests with a lower resolution. And surprise, surprise, the new Q models are very fast with a lower resolution. Well, at least that's true for my system. If you have a different GPU or maybe even less VRAM, then you might have different results. And as I've read, for NVIDIA GPUs, you might have much, much better performance. So for both models, as soon as I had 768 by 768 or lower, the performance increased for both models. And there was something very strange. This is the performance for the 512 by 512. For some reason, the original FP16 model is very slow at this resolution. I've tried several times, but there was no change. And a similar effect was at 704 by 704, whereas the Dev model, there, well, the performance was for some strange reason very bad with the FP16 model. Nevertheless, I'm very satisfied with the increased performance, even at lower resolutions, and when I try new prompts, then I choose some of the lower resolutions, and once after I have finished my tests with the prompt, then I start generating with this prompt and higher resolutions, and this can be done even when I'm not at the PC. Although the file sizes for Q8O and Q4O are different, well, I haven't experienced any difference in performance. That was even independent from the resolution. And the FP8 model was not faster than the very good Q8O model. Sometimes it might have been slightly faster, but when including the loading times, then the Q8O model was faster at all. And in most cases, even the Q8O model was faster than the FP8 model. My key findings regarding GGUF and the new models. On my machine, no difference in performance for higher resolution, but as I said, that might be different with your GPU. The performance increased significantly for lower resolutions. I will not use the FP8 model again. It simply makes no sense, as I now have the Q8O model and the other Q models. If you have a GPU with low VRAM, then start just with the smallest model and increase as long as everything runs with sufficient performance. This is for sure related to the resolution you're using. Regarding the text encoder models, FP8 or FP16, well, there was no difference in performance on my machine. Yes, the FP16 model uses more VRAM, but that was not noticeable on my machine. What I could notice was that using the FP8 or the FP16 model, or changing the models, had an influence on the outputs of the image generation. So if an image does not look as expected, simply change from one to the other, generate again, and maybe you're lucky and the, well, bug in the image will be fixed. As already mentioned, NVIDIA users seem to will benefit even more from these new quantized models, and the models are in ongoing development. So while making this video, I have seen that there are several new dev version and schnell version quantized models, and the GGUF source code has been updated, some bugs have been fixed, LoRa has been added, so that's really a fascinating ongoing development. Which quantized models are most interesting for you? Please write into the comments. I expect performance updates and quantized LoRAs being finalized in the near future. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like.